Welcome back from Tools. You are welcome to our 16th lesson, Digital Environment, under the topic Development of Industries. And today we are going to talk about another example of the third world countries, and that is South Africa. South Africa is found in the south part, the southern part of Africa, where South Africa is, and it's also a country which was colonized by the British, as the same as Kenya. So, my name is Tumboya. Let's look at those factors. Let's look at the history behind South African youth and look at the factors and the challenges that they are facing us in that situation. If concerned, before maybe introduce ourselves to the next other country which is under third world, maybe India. Then, before we move in further, let's look at the lesson objective. So, at the end of the lesson, the lunch should be able to explain the factors influencing industrialization in South Africa. Then give the challenges facing industrialization in South Africa. Here we're going to look at the factors that led to industrialization in South Africa, and also look at the factors that or the challenges that industrialization in Africa is, South Africa is facing. Then there later maybe we may introduce ourselves to the next, which is the third world country in the world, that is India, as far as industrialization is concerned. And the same we will be looking at it in the same way. So South Africa. So she attained majority role in 19, just recently here, 1994. So after a long struggle against the apartheid regime, this was a ruling system that was then supposed to apply to the British in that land, and it was very poor on the people of South Africa. So when that regime, that rule was, when that rule came to an end, after many Africans, people like Lala Madiba Mandela fighting for the independence in South Africa, then that became stopped. So the country has achieved great strides in industrialization with many industries, including iron, steel industries, and also engineering, and also what? Locomotive, chemicals, textile, cement, light industries, and also tourism. These are the sectors of industries. These are the sectors of industry that we went over as far as South Africa is concerned. You can see there are a couple of industrial sectors within that country. So, factors influencing industrialization in South Africa. Let's look at what are the factors influencing industrialization in South Africa. You will be asked that in an exam. Write the factors influencing industrialization. South Africa. So that's what we are going to talk about here. One, the country is endowed with mineral resources such as gold, diamonds. So these gold, diamonds, mineral resources, they will be exchanged for money. That money will be sourced. That money will be used in adjusting the development of industry in the country. Then the next, availability of cheap, both skill and skill labor from the country's large population. South Africa is having large population. These people will provide unskilled and skilled labor to the industry. So that's another factor that enriches those industrial sectors to continue growing. Then the next, availability of natural resources. We have talked about the mineral resources, we also have natural resources. This, for example, mineral supplies like gold, lead, iron, iron ores, uranium, manganese, zinc, xerium, the resins, and also tin. These are just elements. These are elements, chromium, we also have tungsten, we also have phosphate, etc. Some of these resources, those are other factors. These resources could be used by the country, maybe to, as a form of getting money to help in the development, sourcing fund or adding fund in the industry or industrial development in the country. Then the next, development of hydroelectricity that boosted industrialization. So coal is also available for the water, the weak water strand. This a mining ground. This is a place in South Africa where the mining and gold was. So coal is also available to provide what? Provide electricity. Or not electricity, but provide energy in the mining. And also electricity is always coming from the other sources, maybe water and also uranium and so as natural resources on the planet. So South Africa is currently very rich as far as resources of minerals are concerned there. The next factor is that development of transport and communication. Railway line, South Africa is having even electric train. There are some even trains that are moving under the ground. So there's a proper development in terms of transport and communication. Water, road, network and also have been improved, thus opening the resources for the world. Exploitation for transportation of manufactured goods. And air is also a way to develop that enhancing business operations. So through air we can have business internally or international business transaction and together. So the next part is the availability of agricultural form, hard trade in order in other materials. So through the trade, the trade always comes where they pay tax to the government. So through trade that taking place in South Africa, very many times. But that money could be used by the government maybe to source or to provide finance or to give loans to the industrialists to expand, because that was one of the objectives of the country to improve in the industrialization. There are other government has supported industrialization in that country. The government has adopted sound economic policy that promotes industrialization. For example, imposing heavy tariff from the imported commodities such as a means of protecting local industry. So if they realize that you are importing goods from other side, they impose tax, a heavy tax on you so that you can only concentrate on purchasing from the local industry. So that is the one way to which the government has supported them. So the next, encouraging foreign entrepreneurs to invest in the country. They also encourage foreign investors, those white from out there, to go and invest in that country. That supports the development of industry growth, the benefits posed to the country, and also encouraging local investors too. Not only foreign, but also local. Then the next, South Africa is endowed with a variety of tourist attractions, like we have wildlife in South Africa. We also have, which boosted over the tourist industry. Like, example in Kenya, we have very many places. Like here we have the beach sands, and we also have the wildlife and the tourists. Same, South Africa has also an industry under the tourist industry. Then the next, large internal and external markets. So South Africa population, so South Africa also provides the market for the products and goods that are being produced by them. And also some are being exported outside. So the increased trade between South Africa and other countries, especially after the end of the war, after the ruling, has led to the growth of external market. Supplement other available market. There are other countries that buy goods from South Africa because of that. Just supplement the local market. Then after that, let's look at the factors. Let's look at the challenges facing industrialization. What are the challenges facing industrialization as far as South Africa is concerned? We have talked about much about factors what leading or influencing industrial development. I've given you, I think they are almost nine or eight. So let's look at this. As far as there was factors leading to development of industrial development, then there were also factors or challenges that South Africa as a third world country was facing. And Mark, you know that for this country, there's always problems that they are facing. That's why we are not referring to them as superpower. Understand? So when you talk about South Africa, it has had a lot as far as industry is concerned. But then, being that it's a third world country, what's a third world country? A country that is still developing, it's not yet reached as far as the industrial development is concerned. Then there are some challenges that are lagging them behind. There are some problems that are making these countries to lag behind. Then Let's look at this problem. That long period of apartheid, you can see that. I'm sorry for that. So you can see the apartheid. You can see the apartheid rule. The rule that I told you that in South Africa was that was applied by the British in South Africa. This rule really made these people land blind because they were still under the colonial dominance. They were still being ruled by the colonial status. Therefore, they could not concentrate on developing their country for their own industrial demand. So that is one of the ways that make these people black blind. The long period of the dead rule was accompanied with them. Sometimes violent resistance struggle for lower majority rule, which created an atmosphere not conducive for investment. People did not go to that for investment or others. Industries is concerned. So the next, the country suffered long period of economic sanctions imposed by the United Nations between 1948-1994, which affected the manufacturer of goods that did not accept. So sanctions was all about these people, they are being denied an opportunity in the international market. And therefore, that made these people, made them lose a lot of customers in the international market because of the war and the violence that were there. And that was made by United Nations, which was a group of intercollection of different countries. So otherwise, let's make this the end of this first video.